to everybody out there. I'm going to pass a warning to everybody, and this should harm to just men, but I'm just thinking that every man out there has a mother, has a sister, has a girlfriend. So this is a warning to everybody, and I'll tell you what it's all about. Welcome to the show. My name is Mary Swartz. Yes, Scoop and Scoop. The lovely, lovely, lovely Urban TV is bringing you more entertainment than you can take. Tune into Urban on channel 115 on Star Times and on channel 95 on GoTV, and we are everywhere. Regardless of where you migrated to in this digital journey, we are there. So tune into Urban right now and enjoy the best entertainment, including the best from Celebville with yours truly. And I'll catch you tonight on XFM 94.8. Don't forget to tune in when I'm doing TXR, and it's all about your request. And now, let's get dressed inside into the juicy stuff. So here is my warning. Natasha Sinayobe hates men. Yeah? She has turned herself into a tigress who is going to lure you into her world, and she will destroy you. And I'm sure you've watched these Nigerian movies where a girl is raped when she's a child, and then she decides she's going to... The plot is, girl raped as a child. Then makes up her mind that she's... You know Nigerians, they're going to let you into this person's mind, but usually how they do it is just nasty. They let you listen to this person's thoughts while she shakes her head like this. Will they ever move on from that boo? So anyway, this is how the Nigerian movie goes. Girl meets boy while in a dance group. Girl falls madly in love with boy, and boy also falls madly in love with girl. Girl opens her legs so far wide, there is evidence. Evidence is left in this country. Evidence is going to school somewhere. Girl decides to turn into a monster, I think. I don't know. That part of the story, I don't know. But I'm, like I said, it's a Nigerian movie. Follow the plot. Boy has been looking for a visa. Boy has been working on leaving the country for like 6 months. Girl has absolutely no idea. Boy does everything the same way he's been doing it. And girl just wakes up one morning and boy has run off with a white woman. And girl hates men right now. She has just dedicated herself to destroying any man out there. So I know Ugandan men are obsessed with light skin. Let me tell you, light skin is going to be the death of you, especially if you bump into Natasha Sinayobe. She wants to destroy every man that she comes across. She wants revenge, and she's going to take it on every man in this country. Stand warned. Let me tell you, if you wake up one morning and there's a story on the front page, Natasha Sinayobe cuts off man's balls, don't be surprised. That's where she's headed. She's bitter. No, maybe in these Nigerian movies, the woman is raped while she's a child. Natasha, we don't know if she raped, but let me tell you, that man raped her future. He raped her future. He raped her feelings. Michael Kasaja. My God, what happened? You know, this was the love story that everybody loved to hear about. They met when they were kids, they fell in love, even when Ronnie Mulindwa was sleeping with every obsession. Yes, he did. Don't be fooled. So when he was sleeping with every obsession girl, Tasha was untouched. She belonged to Michael. So these two Bambi were living the fairy tale story. Naendo was a saint as I ingiramu. Then Natasha, you're same one. I was told at some point, let me just say it. He already left. So at some point, the money was not coming in as much as she wanted. So she decided to spread her investment elsewhere. So I think Michael got to know, but he did not tell her that he knew. So he was, there was a build up on all these things. But let me tell you something, eh? Regardless of what, Michael moved on from Natasha's print to something else. So now he's going to make white babies. But he's going to make very, very, very light-skinned, nice babies. And then he will take them to Gami and Mip. And he will buy very nice clothes for them. Let me tell you, if you're dying to impress a woman, yeah? If your woman is pregnant, or if your woman is thinking about making babies, or if you just want to your woman to think about making babies, you know Ugandan women, eh? They'll give you all excuses. Me, they removed my uterus when I was a child. I got malaria. So if she's giving you all these excuses, take her to Gami and Mipa. That place will warm up her heart. She'll start to think of her babies wearing those cute stuff. Let me tell you, the cute stuff in there will make even the most, I don't know, the muyaye of the bayayes want to have kids. Gami and Mipa located at Forest Mall, shop number 64. Grab something for your child today. Don't wait for tomorrow. So another somebody we're talking about on the show today is someone else from, I give her too much attention, eh? Well, this is the last time. No, it's because I was having a conversation with a friend of mine and we're just analyzing. She asked me the question, or rather he asked me the question, but let me, he's like, Mary, let me ask, why does Helen Lukoma still sing? And we walked through so many other things and so many, the reason is that there's not, well, what we know Helen for is the fact that she is an actress. I'm not saying that she's best at it, but you know, in Uganda, you don't have to be the best at somebody to, you know, at something. It's just because there are not so many people doing something. So if you are on one successful project, you will be the most successful person. Believe me, why else do you think Chameleon is number one? So anyway, do you remember the hostel and how she stood out and how she tried on that project. And so it makes it look like she's now one of, and you know, she's going to attract roles. But that's why I keep on asking myself, why hasn't Lukoma still got roles? Because the hostel was showing. Kenyans have not, if Kenyans don't call you for roles, Kenyans called Cleopatra Coherent to go and play on some, you know, TV series. And you and I know, okay, well, yeah, maybe. Like I said, there's not that much competition. But no one has called Lukoma. It's like they don't want any actresses. It's like we don't want Ugandans on our series if it's Lukoma to come here. Yay! Me, I'm just thinking that if you're Lukoma Helen, you are on the hostel, it went and showed in Kenya, showed in Nigeria, and nobody has asked you for a role. Boy. Until there's another TV series, Beneath the Light, the words that, never mind, it's been too long. I don't care. So, because that is also not happening anytime soon, and the fact that there are not any other roles, for what Helen is known for is no longer the reason why she's in the news. So what she does is she gets money from Dean, calls him up, then he goes and buys her clothes every time there's a ceremony. You know, when they say soda kumikolo, no, Helen has turned into something else. She's like a microphone on a wedding. It never misses. Because I've been to weddings where there is no soda. There are no kids allowed, so there is no soda. And everybody else, if you're not drinking soda, you will, if you don't drink alcohol, if you don't drink any other strong alcohol, it will be wine. So the wine starts, acts like a non-alcoholic for those who don't drink alcohol. So she's like a microphone. You've never been to a wedding, even the village, the most village wedding where the wedding yakuwaya music navako. Those ones, there's always a microphone, even if they have this big one. Oh, chairman, ya chita wa meeting. You know those ones? At least there's a microphone there. From designer, musician, actress to photo vixen and video vixen. Before we know it, like I said, you will be selling your nyam nyam. This country is not easy. Kampala City Vuga Chama Bafala. And let me tell you, Bafala are not these people you see. Mboba what, they don't speak about celebrity by Uganda. Bafala. She doesn't think beyond what she sees. There's so many ways she can make money. She won't pick my brain for free. But hey, attend parties for my... Nay, the fact that you've already made yourself look like... Who is going to pay? Anyway, Lukoma, but this is what you can do. If you use as much Rexona and as much Vaseline, and if you adopt some Lux soap in your bathroom, this is what is going to happen to you, Lukoma, and all the Lukomas of this world. They are going to reward you. Now that's something. For someone who has nothing going on for their life, at least being rewarded with Rexona will be a good thing for you. At least you'll be like, in all my life, vampire free deodorant. Grab some Rexona today, you will be rewarded for using it. Rexona, you'll be rewarded for using Vaseline, and you'll also be rewarded for using Lux soap. And then you also stand a chance to have your room pimped. Mm-hmm. If you're in university, make sure if you're in MOOC, if you're in KU and UCU, use Rexona double, more than anybody else, and you'll be rewarded double. Love you. Bye-bye.